Earlier, we looked at the Samsung Galaxy S10 5G and how it charged with its display on. This time, we'll take a look at how the phone charges with the phone totally turned off. In this case, we can't use the operating system from Android to be able to tell us the battery charging information. So we'll take a look at how quickly the battery charges on the phone and how the temperature rises using external tools instead. So here again, we'll use the GRLC2 test tool to take a look at how quickly the device charges. We'll also use an external FLIR camera to monitor the temperature. In order to control the C2, we will use the GRL PowerSuite Pro software. We'll first connect the PowerSuite Pro to the C2 tester. Next, we'll go ahead and select the third-party tools tab. And in this tab, we've added the FLIR thermal camera selection, and we can set the data to be shown in a standalone graph. And here we can start the connection by selecting the Enable FLIR button. And now we'll go through a discovery process to find the FLIR camera on the system. The FLIR camera itself is connected to the PC using a USB connector. And we should see that FLIR camera be discovered here. Here we can see that the FLIR itself is called the C2. That is showing up in the discovery window. We'll go ahead and select that. And now we can go ahead and start the connection. Here you can see the thermal image of the Samsung Galaxy S10. Next, we can go ahead and select the test operations and go to the manual port as source. And we can load a PDO profile that we had on the actual Samsung Galaxy S10 5G PPS charger. One of the benefits of using the GRLC2 is that it can emulate any source or sync that's in the market. In this case, we are now emulating the Samsung Galaxy S10 5G PPS charger. This charger has 4 PDOs. So now what we can do is we'll go ahead and press connect, and the automation would actually start the connection process, and the C2 will start. So now what we can do is we'll go ahead and press connect, and the automation would actually start the connection process, and the C2 will start negotiating with the 5G phone, just as if it was the Samsung PPS charger itself. And you can see here in the messages tab, the actual PD negotiations that's going on between the C2 and the phone. In this case, we can see that the phone, after a certain number of transactions, is negotiating using a augmented PDO. That's the 4th PDO here. And then in some various different intervals, it is requesting different voltage and current levels through the augmented PDO. So you can see there's a continuous trace of messages being sent here. And here in the plot window, you can actually see the voltage current being plotted. And we can see that the voltage currently is being in a roughly 9-volt range. And we can also see here that since we started the charging for the Galaxy at close to a dead battery state, we can see that there are several periods of time initially where the phone charges and ramps up its current, drops its current back down to zero, and repeats that for a few times until it seems to have gotten to some sort of a steady state pattern where now the voltage being selected is close to being steady at about 9 volts, and the current being pulled is also steady at about 1.6 amps, which gives close to about a 15 watts power that's being used to charge the Galaxy S10 5G. And we can see here that after the augmented PDOs have been used, interestingly enough, after a certain period of time, the phone switched from a augmented PDO selection to a fixed PDO selection. So it seems like what the Samsung Galaxy S10 5G is doing is that it uses the initial charging phase where the battery is zero and goes to an APDO variable voltage mode, and maybe uses that to quickly charge the phone without adding a lot of temperature. And at the same time, we see that after a while, a negotiation has been done to go back to a fixed PDO. Here we can go back to the temperature screen, and we can see how the overall temperature has been increasing over time. Here the max temperature on the phone is about 37 degrees. So that's a little hotter than the surrounding area outside the phone of about 31 degrees. And we can just leave this running to see how quickly the phone is charging in this fashion and see how hot it gets over a period of time. So we'll go ahead and let this phone charge for a couple hours, and we'll come back to see the results. Overall, we can see that the Samsung Galaxy S10 5G has taken about 6,500 seconds to fully charge from 0 to 100%. However, there are three distinct charging phases for the Samsung Galaxy S10 5G, which we can observe while the phone is off. The first phase involves charging at 25 watts through a very short PPS-based negotiation cycle. The second phase is a much longer 15 watts of fixed voltage and current. And then the third phase is a 9-volt fixed voltage while the current is reduced as the battery charges to a full 100%. If we zoom into the first 25-watt PPS phase, we can clearly see that the Samsung Galaxy S10 5G only achieves 25 watts of charging at very brief periods of time. This is consistent where a lot of phone manufacturers claim very high wattage powers of charging, when in fact they only achieve those high levels during a very brief initial period of charging. We can also see in more detail how Samsung uses PPS technology. Voltage and current both rise at the same time, but they are interspaced with periods of zero current. This is probably a way for Samsung to inject very large amounts of current in a very short period of time without creating a lot of overheating effects. If we compare this overall charging profile to a previous video we did where the phone was kept on, we can see in that case the Galaxy S10 5G stayed in PPS mode in order to keep the overall battery temperature cooler, which was below 35 degrees Celsius. Whereas in this case, while the phone was off, the Galaxy S10 5G stayed mostly in a fixed voltage mode, and rather than trying to keep the phone cool all the time, rather focused on optimizing for faster charging, which it achieved in 108 minutes. The Galaxy S10 5G is a great example of how the new USB PD 3.0 PPS technology can be used to achieve lower temperature under different on and off phone situations.